Hey everyone, today we want to talk about a recent study on the bone health of astronauts that found that 6 months in space can lead to a decade worth of long-term bone loss. NASA defines an astronaut as a person who is trained, equipped, and deployed by a human spaceflight program to serve as the commander or as a crew member aboard a spacecraft. Astronauts go to space for varying amounts of time. However, the typical space mission lasts about 6 months, and some astronauts have stayed in space for over a year. A common destination for astronauts is the ISS, or the International Space Station. On the ISS, astronauts experience microgravity, where they do not feel the effects of gravity and they're able to float freely. The human body has evolved to deal with the force of gravity pulling us down, such as by making our skeletons rigid, so the lack of gravity in space could impact our body significantly. As space agencies are preparing to send astronauts to Mars, a trip estimated to take 9 months each way, it is important for agencies to understand the impacts that space could have on the body. On Earth, our bones experience a constant load on them due to the force of gravity constantly pulling us down. And to support us, our bones have to maintain a certain density. Bones are made up of calcium and a protein called collagen. And in order to maintain optimal density, our bodies have two different cells called osteoblasts and osteoclasts. Osteoblasts add collagen to our bones and increase our bone density, and can be activated in many ways. A primary response that activates these osteoblasts includes sensing a low bone density in our bodies. Osteoblasts constantly survey their area to ensure that our bones are strong enough to support us, but if they sense a decrease in density, osteoblasts put down more collagen in order to support us. Osteoclasts do the opposite of osteoblasts. Osteoclasts are bone breakers, and they work to remove calcium and collagen from our bones when our bodies sense we need more calcium in our blood. Like tug of war, they work opposite to one another. These two types of cells, osteoblasts and osteoclasts, are constantly adding and removing collagen from our bones to maintain an optimal level of bone density throughout all the bones in our bodies.
In space, the bone density that our osteoblasts and osteoclasts maintain changes. The load that our bones have to support is less in space because of the lack of gravity, so less of our osteoblasts become activated. This means that while our osteoclasts continue to break down our bones, less of our osteoblasts are adding collagen back to our bones. This results in bone density decreasing when astronauts go to space, as the balance between the two types of cells has changed. So we know that space can affect someone's bone density, but is there anything that we can do to avoid this issue? The answer is actually yes. According to research, some things that may aid to reduce the amount of bone loss are exercise and resistance training before boarding the ship and while on the ship, creating a diet that includes higher amounts of vitamin D and calcium, as well as taking some medications that help regulate bone growth and loss. Research suggests that in-flight resistance training and exercise should be increased to 3 to 6 times more than what was being done while on land. This amount of activity in space may be sufficient for some astronauts to maintain bone structure and strength. When astronauts are on long flights, they'll experience a change in their normal diet and will have low sunlight exposure. The lack of sunlight exposure may result in a decrease in vitamin D in the body, a nutrient that helps calcium to be absorbed. Calcium is a key player in growing and maintaining bones, and without it being absorbed properly, the bones of astronauts may lose density. To overcome this issue, astronauts can take calcium and vitamin D supplements or try to consume foods that are rich in these nutrients. Astronauts could also look into taking medications that increase the amount of cells that create bones, which are osteoblasts, or decrease the action of the cells that break down bones, which are osteoclasts. The goal of these medications is to reduce the amount of bone being lost so that the astronauts can maintain strength and stay healthy. It is important to remember that each and every astronaut has a different body, and what works for some may not work for others. More research should also be done in order to evaluate how effective these solutions may be. So what about distances beyond 6 months, say 2 years, around the time it takes to go to Mars? One study did show that astronauts who had been in space longer than 6 months experienced permanent bone loss in their shin bones equal to a decade of aging. However, the research is limited and there are not many studies in this area. We would expect that the effects would simply be worse than what they are for trips under 6 months, but it's hard to know for sure what the exact consequences would be. Thank you for watching. We hope that our video helped you learn something new about space and its effects on the bone health of astronauts, and hopefully it inspires you to learn more.